It's me! Hello, everybody! Mr. Pomel here with a really cool pumpkin that I have. It's like a pumpkin and like a spider kind of combined. It's like a pumpkin-antula. Tarantula pumpkin? Tarantula pumpkin? Pumpkin-antula? I don't know. I like both of them. But anyway, my really cool pumpkin-antula, tarantula pumpkin, is here because we're reading a book all about pumpkins today, and not just any old pumpkins. Well, it's not a Pumpkinantula book, but it's about the biggest pumpkin ever. Wow, that looks pretty cool. You know, I don't know about you, but once in a while, I do try to grow things. You know, when I was younger, I used to have a garden with my family. I think we did try to grow pumpkins, because if you think about it, pumpkins come from those little bitty seeds. They grow to really big pumpkins. Well, let's see what this book is about. The Biggest Pumpkin Ever by Stephen Kroll. Oh, look at those little mice on the cover. Look at that. Let's see what happens. The Biggest Pumpkin Ever. Look at that. It's a whole little mouse farm. They got the farmhouse there and all the little vegetables and things they're growing out there. Let's see what they got. I bet they're going to grow a pumpkin. We'll see. Ooh, I like this. In the book here it says, little seeds grow large. That's true if you think about it. You know, little pumpkin seeds can turn into huge pumpkins, but it all starts with that really small seed. So big things can come from little packages. Well, let's get to the story. Once there were two mice who fell in love with the same pumpkin. There's a picture of that garden again. Lots of good stuff going on there. Two mice that both fell in love with that same pumpkin. Clayton, the house mouse, noticed it one day in the vegetable garden. It was still a little green, but Clayton thought he could make it grow really big. It might even get big enough to win the grand prize at the town pumpkin contest. Wow, that would be pretty cool. Grand prize. Look at that. There he is. There's Clayton right there. Kind of look at that little pumpkin. So tiny there. So tiny, but he's imagining. It's bigger than him, and it even has a blue ribbon. That's first place. Ooh, I guess it's possible. Desmond, the field mouse, discovered the pumpkin the same day. He thought that if he helped it grow, it could become the biggest jack-o'-lantern in the neighborhood. That would be kind of cool too, I have to say. So if you look at this one, there's Desmond. He's looking at that same pumpkin, little tiny green pumpkin there. But look at what he's imagining. A pretty cool jack-o'-lantern there. Wow, that would be neat. Pretty big jack-o'-lantern too. That afternoon, Clayton watered the pumpkin. He also mixed up some fertilizer of manure and water. He spread the mixture around the pumpkin to make it grow bigger. That's true. If you give fruit and vegetables and plants and things, water and fertilizer can help them grow. And there he is. Look at that. Spreading it around there. Got exactly what it needs. I see the water there. Oh, look at that. I even see another mouse there, I should say, flying a kite. That's pretty cool. That very same night, Desmond went into the garden. He watered the pumpkin too. He also spread some manure mixed with water around it. Look at that. Clayton went in the middle of the day. Desmond went at night. They probably didn't even know. Look at that. He's spreading some water and some manure to make sure it's nice and healthy. Let's see. The next day, Clayton watered and fertilized the pumpkin again. The next night, Desmond did the same. And the pumpkin began to grow. Look at that. There's Clayton on top. There's Desmond in the middle. And there's the pumpkin getting a little bit bigger. Ooh, let's see what happened. Ooh. By the end of the month, the pumpkin grew so large, Clayton couldn't believe his eyes. Look how big it is. It's still green, so it's not quite ripe yet, but look how big it got. Wow. From that little pumpkin. And look how happy Clayton is. He's like dancing for joy because he's so excited. He's thinking about that contest. I would be excited and happy for him too. Ooh, let's see what happens. My goodness, said Clayton's mother. And it's not even full grown. Clayton shrugged. All I do is water it, he said. Clayton's mother whispered in his ear. If you want the pumpkin to grow bigger faster, she said, you should use sugar water. Sugar water. Maybe that'll help. Clayton's mother's trying to help him there. Give him some recommendations how to help that pumpkin grow even bigger. Well, guess what? That night, Desmond brought his brother Morris to see the pumpkin. Morris knew everything there was to know about growing things. That's some pumpkin, he said. Desmond shrugged. All I do is water it, he said. Morris whispered in his ear. You should try using sugar water, he said. Same idea. Look at that. Morris is trying to help Desmond get the pumpkin to grow too, just like Clayton and his mother. Well, the next day, Clayton dug a small hole beside the pumpkin vine. In the hole, he placed a bowl full of sugar water. He cut the vine a few inches from the pumpkin. In the cut, he put one end of a piece of candle wick, then he put the other end in the bowl of sugar water, so it would kind of like absorb it. That night, on the other side of the pumpkin, Desmond did exactly the same thing. Look at this, they're both doing it again. There it is, you can see there. There's Clayton, got the sugar water, little piece of wick there for the pumpkin vine to help suck it up. And then there on the bottom, there's Desmond trying the same thing. Well, within a week, the pumpkin was twice the size it had been. Within 2 weeks, it was absolutely enormous. Look how big. Wow, look at, he's dancing for joy. He's like, look, from that size to that size, huge, huge pumpkin. Oh, maybe they'll win the contest. Maybe they'll get a great jack-o'-lantern. Clayton was amazed. He ran down the road and peeked into his friend Jimmy's pumpkin patch. The pumpkin Jimmy was growing for the contest looked much smaller. Clayton scratched his head. I have an amazing pumpkin, he said out loud. And I think I'm going to win the contest. It's possible if he does have an amazing pumpkin, because look at that. Jimmy's pumpkin, not quite as big. That night, Desmond and his brother Morris spent a long time looking at that pumpkin.
How do you think it got that big? Desmond said.
Morris shrugged.
A little luck, a little skill.
It's gonna make some jack-o'-lantern, said Desmond.
It sure is.
I agree, that would make some jack-o'-lantern. Look at the size of that pumpkin. It's probably bigger than Morris and Desmond put together.
A week later, Clayton noticed the pumpkin was bigger than the family car.
Can you imagine a pumpkin bigger than a car? Wow.
During the day, everyone he knew came to admire it. And at night, all the field mice, just like Desmond, gathered round to do the same.
They're admiring how amazing and how big it is. All of Clayton and his friends and family during the day, and Desmond's at night.
Well, by now, summer was almost over. In a week, the pumpkin would be full grown and start turning yellowish and then orange. Because then you know a pumpkin's ready when it turns
orange. Like this book. Pumpkin too.
A few weeks after that, it would be ripe and ready for the pumpkin contest. Clayton could hardly wait. The pumpkin was growing so fast, it would soon be bigger than his house. Then he had a terrible thought. If the pumpkin was so big, how would he get it to the contest? It wouldn't fit in his red wagon. It wouldn't even fit in a truck. Well, Clayton decided to worry about this when the time came.
It's true, you're going to have to figure that out. But you can see, look at that. The pumpkin, it almost is bigger than the house. The whole house. And look at that little red wagon there. There it is. Never going to fit that pumpkin in that wagon. What's going to happen?
Well, that night, the weather grew colder. Thinking there might be an early frost, Clayton rushed out to the pumpkin with his blanket. Well, one was not enough. Soon, he was rushing back and forth, carrying all the blankets from the house. As he worked, he hummed a little song.
Kind of putting those blankets. Oh no. It says, as he hummed, he heard someone else singing. He also began to realize that someone else was covering the pumpkin with blankets too. Who do you think it is? I'll show you the whole picture. Well, there's Clayton. Guess who? It's Desmond. Look at all those blankets. They're trying to help keep that pumpkin nice and warm and toasty because you don't want it, you know, a frost. That's when, like, things freeze. That wouldn't be good for a pumpkin or plants or vegetables. Well, Desmond. Desmond, too, had seen the danger of an early frost. He, too, had brought blankets for the pumpkin. And as he worked, he sang a little song. La 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 la, la 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 la. As he sang, he began to realize that someone else was working and humming. They're hearing each other. Oh, are they going to discover that each one of them was kind of taking care of the pumpkin at the same time while the other one was taking care of pumpkin, like during the day and during the night and during the night and during the day? Let's see. Clayton stopped humming. He put down his pile of blankets and peered around the corner of the pumpkin. Desmond stopped singing. He put down his blankets and peered around the corner of the pumpkin. Look at that. They're both trying. They're going to, like, take a peek. What's there? Who's humming? Who's singing? All of a sudden, the two of them bumped heads and fell down.
You've been feeding the pumpkin?
Said Clayton.
You've been feeding the pumpkin?
Said Desmond.
That's why it got so big, said Clayton.
That's why it got so big, said Desmond.
They burst out laughing.
How funny, because they were both watering it. It got like double the water and double the fertilizer. That's how it got so big. You can see they're both laughing and kind of having fun.
Oh, very cool. But let's see. When everything had been explained, Clayton said,
I know I'll win the contest if I can get the pumpkin to town.
Desmond smiled.
I'll help you. Just let me carve the pumpkin into a jack-o'-lantern for Halloween when the contest is over.
It's a deal, said Clayton.
A deal, said Desmond.
And they shook on it. Shake hands. That's a deal. Look at that. Working together, you know. Interesting, because, If Clayton or Desmond kind of, if they didn't work together as well, one of them could have said, it's my pumpkin, go away, you can't have it. But no, they're kind of being friendly and working together. Pretty cool. Well, the morning of the contest was bright and sunny. Mice were bringing their pumpkins to the town square by truck and car and wagon. Some were even rolling them along the ground. Look at all the pumpkins on their way to the pumpkin contest. I see on a strapped on the roof of a car there, in the back of a truck, rolling them on a little skateboard, a scooter, or a wagon there. All of those pumpkins. There's lots of pumpkins. Wow. But these pumpkins don't look as big as you know which one. Suddenly, they all stopped short. Over the fields came the biggest pumpkin anyone had ever seen. It was being pulled by 100 field mice on motorcycles. 100 field mice on motorcycles. That's how many they need because it was so big. Look at that. That must have been a sight. All those motorcycle mice pulling that pumpkin, but working together. Well, look at that. All of the mice in town, they're kind of like amazed. Oh, I'll show you the whole picture. They're looking and saying, wow, what could that be? It's a pretty huge, pretty massive pumpkin. That's pretty amazing there. Oh, look at this pumpkin, even all kind of, this pumpkin, this mouse, I should say, all kind of dressed up in his top hat there and suit. When the pumpkin reached town, it was too big for any of the streets. Clayton had to explain why they couldn't bring it into the square. The mayor understood at once. He led the crowd to the giant pumpkin and pinned the first prize ribbon on its side. Then everyone danced around it. They were so excited. Who would have believed this? Clayton said as he danced. Who would have believed this? Desmond said at the same moment. How excited. There they are. All the mice are super excited. The mayor pinning on that ribbon there. Pretty cool. Pretty amazing. The pumpkin won first prize. Oh! Well, when the celebration was over, the 100 field mice pulled the pumpkin back to the field. The day before Halloween, they carved it into the best jack-o'-lantern ever. You know what? If it's a pretty big pumpkin, that would probably make a pretty amazing jack-o'-lantern. Look at that. Wow. Pretty cool. Look at all that. You see them planning here. They're kind of writing down what they want to do. And then they're carving some eyes. And I see a nose coming in there. And look at that. They got all the seeds out. All of those pumpkin seeds. Oh, and they even have like a candle there. Probably going to go on the inside to light it up once they're done. Wow. That's a pretty amazing pumpkin. And they're turning it into a pretty spectacular jack-o'-lantern. Well, on Halloween night, its wonderful, smiling face could be seen glowing for miles around. Because it was such a huge pumpkin. Look at that. Such amazing. So amazing. What a great pumpkin there. And a huge jack-o'-lantern. Miles around. And look at this. These mice are even, they're even dressed up in their Halloween costumes. It looks like this one is maybe a clown or something. And oh, it's like a ghost mouse. And oh, a little like a little witch mouse there. With little witch broom. Well, that was the story of the biggest pumpkin ever. And you know what? Look at the back. There they are. Clayton and Desmond celebrating. Dancing around their pumpkin. Super excited. Why? Because it was a great pumpkin. Because it was an amazing jack-o'-lantern. Because it won the contest. And because they could work together. And together, they were able to make it the biggest pumpkin ever. Pretty cool. Hopefully you enjoyed that. I know for sure Tarantula Pumpkin, Pumpkin Angela, loved it too. Hopefully you enjoyed it. That was The Biggest Pumpkin Ever by Stephen Kroll. That's it for today though. Can't wait to read the next book. Until then, Mr. Pomel signing off. See you later, everybody. Bye.